Hey, how's it going, guys? Matt here from Toasty DIY, and I'm here with a very quick video on a program that I actually have been utilizing a lot recently. With working from home becoming way more prevalent, I've been having to remote into our office a lot more. Now, luckily for us, we haven't had any issues here having to be able to go into our office. We have pretty good protocols in place, and we haven't had any major issues going into the office and making sure everyone's staying safe. But there have been situations where I'm having to stay home and I don't go into the office, and I've been needing to work on my computer. Now, previously, I was using TeamViewer, the free version. Eventually, TeamViewer started to detect that I was using it a lot for commercial use, not just personal use, which I do debate. I think it's still technically personal use. But regardless, when I did start using that, I was having issues where TeamViewer would time me out unless I paid for a license. And when they did want me to pay for a license, it was incredibly expensive. It was like $40 a month or something stupid like that. And TeamViewer isn't worth that much. So what I decided to do was look at some other alternatives, and I ended up watching a video from the Linus Tech Tips team and learned more about this. This is Parsec. Now, I have originally been using the Parsec free version, so I'm going to be talking mainly about the free version of Parsec, but Parsec has a paid version for $10 a month, which is way cheaper than the TeamViewer version, that has a lot of cool things baked in, and we're going to go ahead and dive into this and show you exactly how it works. Now, the beauty of Parsec is the fact that it was originally designed for game streaming, but a lot of people have been using it to work from home because of its encoding and decoding capabilities using H.265, which allows for some really high quality and low latency streaming from the host to the client. For example, I have my office PC that is streaming its video signal or its desktop or whatever to my PC here at home, which for me, we're really close, so the latency is significant. Lower considering it's right down the street, but even if you are working around the world, you can get some pretty good low latency experience by doing this. So what we're going to be doing is connecting to my office PC, which is super simple right here. What's going to do is boom, pop up right here, and as you can see, I have access to my desktop at the Toasty Bros office. Now, why is something like this useful for me? Well, one thing that we have in our video editing process is what we like to call the review period, where I mainly review our video editor McAllister's work. And we have a NAS that is locally at our office, and I could technically use the NAS's built-in online software to watch back the files, but unfortunately our NAS is only gigabit, therefore the transfer speeds are really slow, and playing back 4K footage over this software is very choppy and very inconsistent. So remoting directly into the PC that has a direct connection to this NAS is the best option. So as you can see right here, if you go into our Toasty Bros folder and our render video folder, we have all our rendered videos here. So let's say, for example, I just finished watching the draft of this video that's going to be going live on the channel. What I can do from here is do my review notes from home, because we go to the office, we're done hanging out there, blah, blah, blah. I want to come home and chill out for a little bit, and then I can go back and do some reviews and give McAllister notes on our Trello doc that allows us to update all the information and things like that. I actually just finished a review session. So let's go ahead and play this video back.
Hey, how's it going, guys? Jack and Matt here with the Toasty Bros, and normally we really love budget, but today...
So as you can tell, I can get just normal playback of a rendered draft, no problems whatsoever. I can even go into here and just open up, let's open up a raw file, which is basically our video editing timeline. We'll go to this. This may not work perfectly because McAllister sometimes keeps some of his files locally on his computer and I can't pull all them up. So you'll see here in a second if he made an oopsie. Actually, it looks like he did everything right. Go McAllister, I'm proud of you. But I can actually edit from here using the horsepower of the PC at the office and have no problems whatsoever. I've actually edited a video once through Parsec, and there is some latency, don't get me wrong. And the color accuracy isn't as nearly clear as if you're editing locally. So if you're not doing any crazy color specific work, you can easily go in via Parsec, do some video editing, chop things up, render it out, and have no issues putting a lot of load on your PC. So this could be a good option for those with cheaper laptops that, let's say, have a work PC that they can work at and they can work from home. If you're a business, you can have that workstation be remoted into somebody's cheap laptop they have at home, have no issue bogging down that laptop, and be able to do all the work they had to that was more intensive on their main work PC. So that's why this program is so powerful and why it's been really good for work from home situations, because it's super easy to set up and people can just remote in to their work PC and act like they have not left the office. Now you can see right here, I only have a network latency of about 22 milliseconds, which is not that bad given the fact that I'm just doing video editing. For video editing, it's perfectly fine, but one of the main downsides of the non-paid version is the fact that you only get a single screen here. Now, normally I would not complain about that, but if you're remoting into a PC with a dual monitor or multi-monitor setup, sometimes you may leave your PC with something scattered off on, let's say, the top monitor or the right monitor or somewhere where it doesn't need to be, and you can't get it. Like, you absolutely cannot get it without closing it out or getting a hotkey to work, and sometimes certain hotkeys will not work when you're remoted in. So there is an issue there, but with the paid version at $10 a month, you do get second screen. So let's just go ahead and pull this second screen here, which is actually a portrait monitor, which, again, I don't think they actually have support for that. I could totally be wrong. I don't think they can adjust this. I might be able to change the resolution. Let's see if that works. Wow, look at that. I can go ahead and change the resolution to normal 1920 by 1080 and use it as a second monitor and then switch it back to portrait. So I can do that if I wanted to. And then I can have like a dual monitor setup on a single screen, which is kind of weird. But ideally, I'd probably just move this over to my other screen that's right here, set it up, and I would be good to go. Yeah, I have a dual monitor setup as long as that works. Yeah, look at that. Dual monitor setup. Works perfectly. I can do my video editing here, watch videos, and be remoted in on another PC, which is absolutely cool. I know this is probably nothing new to a lot of people who use remote software, but I think this is really cool. Some of the other stuff you can do is change the bandwidth. Right now, I'm only doing 10 megabits per second. It's really low, and it still looks super sharp. This is like the default speed. You can go all the way up to 50 if you want to, if you have a high internet connection. Constant FPS, you can change the resolution. You can switch between multiple displays with the paid version, of course. You get 444 for color sampling, which basically is higher quality color with the paid version. If that's something that's interested to you, you could just run the full version. As I mentioned, you can use different decoders. If you have an NVIDIA GPU, you get NVIDIA decoding capabilities to get higher quality playback. The codec, which is set to auto, it really doesn't matter. It's normally just going to be H.265, as I mentioned. You get full sound, you get full screen, you could chat with the other user. And yeah, that's basically Parsec. It's super simple to use. Absolutely love it. Just install it on the host PC, install it on this PC, make an account, and get everything up and running. So that's pretty much it. My quick review of Parsec is that it's absolutely awesome. Is it perfect? No, it has some issues, but I do think the paid version is 100% worth the money if you're somebody looking to get into some remote working from home. I know it's a very niche thing. I know a lot of you don't really care, but one thing you can do is you have a friend who has a really baller gaming PC. You can remote into his gaming PC and play games as well. That's kind of like a fun feature that you can use Parsec for. But overall, really cool. Love this program. I'm glad I saw the video from the Linus Tech Tips team, because it's become very useful in helping me totally ditch TeamViewer and not have to look at it ever again. So if you're interested in downloading Parsec, link in the description down below. And if you guys do like this video, be sure to drop a like, comment what you think of it, and hopefully I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.